Good morning, everyone. My name is Shyam Sundar, and I'm the lead investigator for NIST, the National Institute for Standards and Technology. Today, I will be reviewing our final conclusions on the collapse of World Trade Center Tower 7, which fell on the afternoon of September 11, 2001. After years of intensive investigation, we have concluded that standard office fires caused one support column to fail, which caused a chain reaction, knocking down the entire building. Thank you. Goodbye. Now, calm down, everyone. I was told I have to take some questions, which I think is an extraordinarily bad idea, but whatever. Yes, you have a question.
Thank you. I'm Rick Blair from the American Engineering Association. It seems impossible from an engineering perspective that a single column failure could cause all the other columns in a structure to simultaneously fail, as we saw in Tower 7 on the morning of 9/11.
That was not a question, that was a statement. If you don't have a question, then sit down and shut up.
Sorry. My question is, how did you determine that a single column failure caused the collapse?
We used science. Duh.
What kind of science?
Proper science, legitimate science, with data and formulas and shit like that. Yes?
Will you make the scientific calculations which support your conclusions available for peer review?
No, we have decided that we do not need to submit our work for peer review. In fact, we have classified our critical data so that no one can see it.
Then how are we supposed to know how you came to your conclusions?
Look, we employ scientists with degrees. That means they are really smart, and they don't need the work double-checked because they don't make mistakes. Case closed. Next question.
But, sir, how can any legitimate engineer endorse your findings if you refuse to show how...
Case closed. Next question.
Good eye. This is Chase Sparks from Fire Investigation International. Structural engineers and demolition experts from around the world agree that the collapse of World Trade Center 7 has all the characteristics of a controlled explosive demolition.
Do you asshole people understand the difference between the question and a statement? Who, what, where, when, how, why? Those are questions. If you are just going to make asshole statements, then I am going home.
Fine. My question is, did you find any residue of explosives in the debris?
No. Our team found no evidence of explosive residues.
Can you tell me what tests you performed in order to confirm that?
We did no testing.
Then how did you know there was no explosives if you didn't test for them?
Why waste time testing for something we know is not there?
Look, mate, we know the regulations. Any fire investigation where the entire building structure has been demolished, it's standard to test for explosives, as mandated by NFPA 921-19.
We at NIST consider the NFPA codes to be more of a suggestion than a mandate, because in this case, we already knew there was no explosives.
But you're avoiding the question. How did you know there were no explosives in the building?
Simple logic. There is no way the 19 hijackers responsible for the 9/11 attack could have put explosives in the building. Therefore, there are no explosives.
But isn't that assuming that no one else could have been involved in the attack?
Because no one else was involved in the attack. Unless you are one of those crazy conspiracy theorists who think that President Bush did it. Ah, but President Bush was in Florida that morning, so he could not have put explosives in the building. Therefore, all your conspiracy theorists are crazy and baseless, and you can shut the fuck up and go away. Next question.
Thank you. I'm Corey Samples from the American Metallurgy Association. How did your team explain the melting of steel girders if, as you say, there was nothing hotter than standard office fires in those buildings?
Our team found no evidence of melted steel.
But the melting of steel girders was documented in Appendix C of the FEMA report, along with a recommendation to investigate the cause. So unless your team is deliberately ignoring evidence, why didn't you investigate it?
Because we did not need to investigate it. We knew when we started this investigation what caused these buildings to collapse. It was aircraft damage and fire and gravity and nothing else. That's what happened because that's what we say happened. You seem to forget. We are the experts, not you. Yet you assholes want to nitpick every little detail. Oh, controlled demolition better explains this, and your conclusion does not explain that. What science tells us is that sometimes you can't explain everything. Sometimes strange and impossible things happen. The laws of physics do not always apply, and they surely did not apply on 9/11. How does gravity alone make a basically intact steel and concrete structure suddenly and submetrically collapse with little more resistance than thin air? It shouldn't happen once, much less three times in one day in one location. And my job depends on making logical sense out of that? So what do? Do we thoroughly investigate every little detail? Do we try to answer every question? No! We hide away all of the evidence that we have the best we can, and then we get an educated person in a lab coat to tell us what makes us feel good. Like, there is a perfectly logical and reasonable explanation for those buildings to fall the way they did. We can trust our government to always tell the truth. We can trust our media to always tell the truth. And all of our friends and family serving in the armed forces, killing and dying in Afghanistan, is justified and not some imperialist PNAC conspiracy. And why do we do this? Because it allows us to go on with our lives and put these unanswered questions behind us. Like the ostrich, we put our head in the sand because if we can't see the danger, then the danger does not exist. And maintaining the status quo is more important than the goddamn truth.
I apologize. I think I got a little emotional.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes, thank you very much. Yes. That's right. USA, USA.
And so it was that although the NIST investigation reports were politically motivated, completely unscientific, and refused to reveal the key calculations that explained their conclusions, the consensus among the scientific community was to not only endorse these reports, but to ridicule and discredit anyone who dares to question the reports, thus ensuring the multi-billion dollar war on terror would continue, the erosion of civil liberties and constitutional rights would continue, and the illusion of the American dream would continue.